Welcome to the Chapel of St Dorothy on this Good Friday. Today we reach the second day of the Triduum. Today, Jesus having been arrested, we remember how he was mocked, scourged, denied justice, and put to death. And we marvel that it was for us, for you and for me, and for the forgiveness of our sins that all this took place. I invite you to come with us to our Good Friday liturgy. Let us pray. Almighty Father, look with mercy on this your family for which our Lord Jesus Christ was content to be betrayed and given up into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who is alive and glorified with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have failed you as did your disciples. We ask for your mercy and your help. We are often slow to follow the example of Christ. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
We often fail to be known as Christ's disciples. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
We often fail to walk in the way of the cross. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So the soldiers and their officer with the Jewish police arrested Jesus and bound him. First, they took him to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jews that it was better to have one person die for the people. Simon Peter and another disciple followed Jesus. Since that disciple was known to the high priest, he went with Jesus into the courtyard of the high priest, but Peter was standing outside at the gate. So the other disciple, who was known to the high priest, went out, spoke to the woman who kept the gate, and brought Peter in. And the woman said to Peter, "Are you not also one of this man's disciples?" He said, "I am not." Now the slaves and the police had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were standing around it, warming themselves. Peter was also standing with them and warming himself. Then the high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his teaching. And Jesus answered, "I have spoken openly to the world. I have always taught in synagogues and in the temple. Where are all the Jews come together? I have never said anything in secret. So why do you ask me? Ask those who heard what I said to them. They know what I said." When he had said this, one of the police standing nearby struck Jesus on the face, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?" Jesus answered, "If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, then why do you strike me?" Then Annas sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself, and they asked him, "You are not also one of his disciples, are you?" He denied it and said, "I am not." One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, "Did I not see you with him in the garden?" And again Peter denied it. And at that moment the cock crowed. Then they took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. It was early in the morning. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so as to avoid ritual defilement and to be able to eat the Passover. So Pilate went out to them and said, "What accusation do you bring against this man?" They answered, "If this man were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you." Pilate said, "Well, take him yourselves and judge him according to your law." They replied, "We are not permitted to put anyone to death." This is to fulfill what Jesus had said when he indicated the kind of death he was to die. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own account, or have others spoken to you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king, and for this I was born. For this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Pilate asked him, "What is truth?" After he had said this, he went out to the Jews again and told them, "I can find no case against him. But you have a custom that I release for you at the Passover a prisoner. Now, do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" They all shouted in reply, "Not this man, but Barabbas." Now Barabbas was a bandit. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged, and the soldiers wove a crown of thorn and placed it on his head, and they dressed him in a purple robe, and they kept coming up to him and saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and striking him on the face. Pilate went out again and said to them, "Look, I am bringing him out to you so that you know I find no case against him." So Jesus came out, wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. And Pilate said to them, "Behold the man." When the chief priests and the police saw him, they shouted, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no case against him." The Jews answered him, "We have a law, and according to that law he ought to die, because he has claimed to be the Son of God." Now when Pilate heard this, he was more afraid than ever. He entered his headquarters again and asked Jesus, "Where are you from?" But Jesus gave no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, "Do you refuse to speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to release you and power to crucify you?" Jesus said to him, "You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore the one who handed me over to you is guilty of a greater sin." From then on, Pilate tried to release him, but the Jews cried out, "If you release this man, you are no friend of the emperor. Everyone who claims to be a king sets himself against the emperor." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out, sat on the judge's bench at a place called the Stone Pavement, or in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover, and it was about noon. And he said to the Jews, "Here is your king." They cried out, "Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!" Pilate asked them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king, but the emperor." And then he handed him over to them to be crucified. So they took Jesus and carrying the cross by himself, he went out to the place which is called a place of the skull, which in Hebrew is Golgotha. There they crucified him and two others with him, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. Then the chief priests of the Jews said to Pilate, "Do not write, 'The King of the Jews,' but 'This man said, I am the King of the Jews.'" Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written." When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from top to bottom. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots." And this is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. And after this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there, so they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. The cross of Christ,
the cross on which the Saviour of the world was hung.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Christ was manifested in the body, vindicated in the spirit, seen by angels, proclaimed among the nations, believed in throughout the world, glorified in high heaven. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
O Saviour of the world, who by your cross and precious blood have redeemed us, Save us and help us, we humbly pray. Faithful cross above all other, one and only noble tree. None in foliage, none in blossom, none in fruit thy peer may be. Sweetest wood and sweetest iron, sweetest wedges hung on thee. Bend, O lofty tree, thy branches, thy two rigid sinews bend, and awhile the stubborn hardness which thy birth bestowed suspend, and the limbs of heft thy monarch gently on thine arms extend. Thou alone wast counted worthy this world's ransom to sustain, that by thee a wretched creation might its ark and haven gain. With the sacred blood anointed of the Lamb that hath been slain.
Let us pray for the Church of God throughout the world, for Peter, our bishop, and the priests and people of this diocese, for all Christians and for those to be baptized, that God will confirm his church in faith, increase it in love, and preserve it in peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for the nations of the world and their leaders, for Elizabeth, our Queen, and the parliaments of this land, for those who administer the law and all who serve in public office, for all who strive for justice and reconciliation, that by God's help the world may return to order and health. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for God's ancient people, the Jews, the first to hear his word, for greater understanding between Christian and Jew, that God will grant us grace to be faithful to his covenant and to grow in the love of his name. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for those who do not believe the gospel of Christ, for those who have not heard the message of salvation, for all who have lost faith, for the contemptuous and scornful, for those who are enemies of Christ and persecute those who follow him, for all who deny the faith of Christ crucified, that God will open their hearts. Let us pray for all of those who suffer, for all who are sick, troubled or oppressed, for those in darkness, in despair, in loneliness or in fear, for prisoners, captives, and refugees, for the victims of false accusations and of violence, for all at the point of death and those who watch beside them, that God, in his mercy, will sustain them with the knowledge of his love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favourably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery, and by the tranquil operation of your perpetual providence, carry out the work of our salvation. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Bless you and keep you now and always. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Most merciful God, who by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.